Welcome, and thanks for tuning into this episode of Corecast. I'm Jennifer LaVista. The U.S. Geological Survey and the Coast Salish Tribal Nation have partnered during the annual Tribal Journey to study and help improve resources of the Salish Sea. This first video in the Corecast Tribal Journey series examines the new partnership between the Coast Salish and the USGS.
To put our location in perspective, we're about 2 hours north of Seattle. The Swinomish canoe family will be leaving Laconer and making their way up to Ana Cortez today.
Canoes will land at their final destination in Cowichan, British Columbia on July 28th. I met up with Swinomish skipper Eric Day to learn more about the Tribal Journey.
The Tribal Journey is an annual event that goes on every year, and one tribe agrees to host, and basically all the other tribes get in their canoe and travel there. And it's basically to commemorate how our ancestors used to travel. What I've been seeing for sure is the fish declining, the fisheries declining. I think our fishermen, they're lucky to get 2-3 days out of the year for fishing sockeye. And when I was fishing sockeye, you know, just out of high school, we were out there for like 2 weeks. Sometimes we'd be out there 3 weeks. That's basically why I got out of the fisheries, because, you know, I saw that happening. And you know, there's a lot of dead zones down in South Puget Sound area. You hear that on the news all the time. They're talking about how the oxygen level, in especially in the Hood Canal, is declined way down. And you know, you always hear on the news about the water temperature rising, and you know, the fish they don't like it when it's warm.
We have several projects within the USGS that work on issues related to habitats and water quality. And one of them is the Coastal Habitats in Puget Sound project. That is a project that is integrating scientists from biology, geology, hydrology, chemistry, geography, to answer certain problems related to land use and its impact on nearshore habitat and environments. As part of that project, we work here in the Skagit Delta, and over the last 2 or 3 years, I've been working quite closely with the Swinomish Tribe and the Skagit River System Cooperative, who supports the Swinomish Tribe. We had several conversations about other types of opportunities for conducting the science, and it was mentioned that there's an annual canoe journey, and it dawned on me that a great methodology would be fastening these water quality probes behind multiple canoes during the summer journey and having the canoes mapping out the water bodies across the Salish Sea.
Eric Grossman was coming up here to actually in Skagit Bay, doing a lot of water testing within Skagit Bay. And I don't know when he came up with the idea, but him and Deborah Lakanoff, they pulled me aside and asked me what I thought, you know, the other canoe skippers would think if we did a water quality test out on the water. We brought it out and we was like, well, we don't know if you guys want to do this, but you know, like 7-8 people would come up and say, yeah, we'll take a probe. Yeah, we'll take a probe. Yeah, you know, and we only had 5 probes. And I mean, when we first started, we were thinking maybe 1, 2, you know, and then pretty soon, like, we had 20 people ready to say, hey, let's do it. You know, we want to do it.
So this is a multi-parameter water quality probe. This particular one is from YSI, Environmental International. And it's multi-parameter in terms of being able to measure a number of water quality properties. We have a temperature sensor, a conductivity sensor, a pH sensor, depth, and these larger ones are optical turbidity and optical dissolved oxygen. And this will be traveling behind the canoe, being towed by the canoe in the surface water, meaning the upper half meter of the water column, and measuring those water parameters every few seconds, but recording every 10 seconds. And along with this is a fancy handheld marine GPS that will be tagging those measurements every 10 seconds. So we have a fixed position along the water. And these data are integrated in a small handheld computer here, again, every 10 seconds. And what we will do is log the entire journey from takeoff point in the morning to ending point in the afternoon, and simply download the data when it arrives to shore. And that data file then is emailed into our central server at Washington Water Science Center, and Ray Julek will be mapping them up almost near real time every afternoon, and displaying the results on a Google Map interface for the world to see. So these different parameters that we'll measure will be mapped out this year behind canoe along six or so different pathways. And essentially this year will just be a baseline mapping of conditions in late July 2008. But they might lead to important anomalies and important areas of water quality concern that we can return to and study in a little more detail.
The Coastal Salish Tribal Nation's invitation to us to join in this science project really is an honor for us to have an opportunity to be with them on this annual journey that they take. And it's really given us an opportunity for them to share with us their traditions, their values, their culture. So it's a great opportunity for us.
The hope is to integrate this with the traditional local knowledge of the Coast Salish people. They've canoed these waters, they fish these waters, they live off these waters for the last hundreds of years, thousands of years, and they have an understanding of the different characteristics of the environment, where fish were plentiful, where eelgrass was healthy, where there was turbidity, where there wasn't, and we might be able to marry some of this science with their long-standing knowledge to better understand sort of recent trends.
Well, I hope to see this partnership continue to strengthen and grow and to expand to a number of the other tribes in the area. I think, again, it's a great opportunity to marry our science with the traditional knowledge and to help share information about changes that are occurring here in the ecological system, and to provide some information to better inform the policymakers and the resource managers.
Stay tuned to usgs.gov/coastsalish for upcoming videos, daily water quality data, photos, and much more. Corecast is a product of the U.S. Geological Survey, Department of the Interior. Until next time, I'm Jennifer LaVista.